Hello! Today we're going to take a look at simplifying algebraic expressions with parentheses. Before we do that, let's review what like terms are. Like terms are any two terms that have the same variable raised to the same exponent. So some examples of like terms are x squared and 7x squared. 3xy and 4xy are also examples of like terms, and so are 2x and 5x. Now, an example of two terms that are not like terms would be 6x and 6x squared. Even though they have the same coefficient and the same variable, the variables are not raised to the same power, so these two terms are not like terms. The coefficients for like terms can be different, and in fact, they usually are. So like here, 2x and 5x are like terms, even though the coefficient 2 is different from the coefficient 5. So now that we've reviewed what like terms are, let's use this information to simplify some expressions. So we're going to start with the expression 3x squared plus 2x minus 5, and add that to 7x squared minus 3x plus 14. Since all our terms are being added or subtracted, we can use the associative and commutative properties to regroup our terms so our like terms are next to one another. Remember, subtracting can be thought of as adding a negative, so these properties will still work. So let's combine our like terms. Our like terms are 3x squared and 7x squared, 2x and negative 3x, and negative 5 and 14. So we're going to regroup and write them this way. We're going to do 3x squared plus 7x squared. Then we'll add our next set of like terms, 2x minus 3x plus our last set of like terms, negative 5 plus 14. Now we can simplify each set of parentheses. So 3x squared plus 7x squared is 10x squared. 2x minus 3x is negative x, so we have plus negative x plus negative 5 plus 14 is 9. Now we can simplify this just a little bit further by changing this adding a negative number to just subtracting. So our final answer is going to be 10x squared minus x plus 9. Since this isn't an equation, we can't solve for anything. The most we can do is simplify. So this is our final answer. Let's try another example. X plus 2xy minus 3y plus negative 17x minus 9xy plus 27y. So first we're going to regroup our terms so our like terms are together. So let's start by underlining our like terms. We have x and negative 17x as like terms, 2xy and negative 9xy are like terms, and negative 3y and 27y are also like terms. So now we can write them in parentheses. We have x minus 17x plus 2xy minus 9xy plus negative 3y plus 27y. And now all we have to do is simplify each set of parentheses. So x minus 17x is negative 16x. 2xy minus 9xy is negative 7xy, so we're just going to do minus 7xy. And negative 3y plus 27y is 24y, so we're going to add 24y. So our final answer is negative 16x minus 7xy plus 24y. Before we go, I want to try one more example that's slightly more difficult. 6x squared plus 4x minus 2 minus 2x squared minus 18x plus 5. So notice that this expression has a minus sign between the two sets of parentheses. Remember how I said earlier that subtracting is the same thing as adding a negative? This will help us in simplifying this expression. So let's rewrite this as 6x squared plus 4x minus 2 plus negative 1 times 2x squared minus 18x plus 5. So this is where the adding a negative number comes in. But the negative number has to be 1 because that doesn't change the value of the actual expression. 1 times anything is the original expression. So this doesn't change the value of anything, it just makes it look slightly different so we can understand where our next steps come from. So now that we have a negative 1 here, we need to distribute this negative 1 into each term in the second set of parentheses. So we're going to leave this first set of parentheses exactly the same. 6x squared plus 4x minus 2 plus negative 1 times 2x squared is negative 2x squared. Negative 1 times negative 18x is plus 18x. And negative 1 times positive 5 is negative 5. So notice that we have the exact same set of parentheses, just the sign has changed in front of each term. So now we're going to follow the exact same steps as we have before. We're going to underline our like terms. So we have 6x squared and negative 2x squared. 4x and 18x are also like terms. And so are negative 2 and negative 5. So now we're going to regroup these like terms into their own sets of parentheses. So we'll have 6x squared minus 2x squared plus 4x plus 18x plus negative 2 minus 5. Now we'll simply simplify each set of parentheses. So 6x squared minus 2x squared is 4x squared. 4x plus 18x is 22x. And negative 2 minus 5 is negative 7. So our final answer is 4x squared plus 22x minus 7. And there you have it. I hope that this video made this topic more understandable for you. Thanks for watching and happy studying.